This is Throne of Dragons, Age of the Sorcerers, Book 2, written by Morgan Rice, narrated by Kevin E. Green. Chapter 1. When Lenore woke, for one beautiful second, she thought that it had all been a nightmare. She could feel the softness beneath her, and she saw the simple comfort of the inn's room, and she assumed that the awful things she remembered must have been no more than the terrors of the dark. They couldn't be real. They were. Lenore knew it a second later as consciousness came back to her. Knew it in the bruises and the pain. She shook her head, trying to make herself not think about where she was, but she could no more hold back those thoughts than she could hold back an ocean. The quiet men King Ravin had sent for her had kept her here, a prisoner. When she tried to break free, they'd beaten her. Aeris and Cyrell were the worst. Lenore forced herself to look around, to think of anything else but this. The room at the top of the inn was empty now, except for her, and Lenore knew this might be the only chance she would get to survive this. Shaking, having to ignore the pain with every motion she made, Lenore started to stand. She fell against the bed for a second, catching herself, but she didn't fall back. If she let herself fall back, she wouldn't get up again, and then she would just be waiting for them to carry her away to King Ravin's lands.
"I will be strong," she told herself.
She made her way to standing. She didn't look much like a princess now. Her dress had tears in it from the violence of her capture, but Lenore pulled it back on anyway, tying the torn elements together as best she could. She padded toward the door on silent feet. Outside she could hear Aeris and Cyrell talking, and Lenore's heart hammered in her chest, fearing that they might be about to come back inside.
"Sure we don't have time to tarry here with the princess?"
Cyrell asked in that wheedling, half-mad voice of hers.
"We need to get her back to the south, my love,"
Aeris said.
"And if you hurt her too much, she won't transport easily."
"King Ravin is no fun,"
Cyrell said.
"And when I tell him you said that, what do you think he'll do to you?"
Aeris shot back.
"No, we leave in an hour. We'll head for the nearest bridge and be across soon enough. Remember to leave some of the maids alive. King Ravin wants them to talk."
He wanted them to talk? Lenore found herself caught between happiness that at least some of her servants were still alive, and horror at all the things they must have suffered alongside her, fear of how many of them might have died, and confusion, because why would King Ravin want any of them alive to tell people that he had King Godwin's daughter? That didn't matter right then. The only thing that mattered was trying to get away. She'd tried that before, though, and hadn't got even as far as the stables. How was she supposed to get away when she'd already been caught once, when they had shown that they could catch her whatever she tried? No, she wouldn't give up. She couldn't. Once they got her beyond the river, how could anyone hope to escape from there? It had to be now, while they were occupied, while they still thought that she was helpless and caught here. Knowing that there was no way out through the door, Lenore went over to the window. It was chipped and sticking, hard enough to open that Lenore was sure it would creak and protest as she pushed the shutters apart, giving away what she was doing to anyone listening. Lenore opened it and froze in place, waiting to see if there was any reaction. No one burst into the room, though. No one shouted or raised an alarm. Lenore looked over the ground below her. There was a low roof for the floor below, and beyond that the open space beyond the inn, with a courtyard leading over to the stables. There were bodies in that now, dragged into a pile as if they were mere refuse, something that didn't matter at all to the quiet men who had killed them. Lenore could see some of those quiet men now, no longer dressed in peasant garb, but in dark leathers and dulled scale armour that made them look ready to fight an army's worth of foes. One, a woman, was standing over a group of four of Lenore's servants. She pointed to two and set them running, far enough away that Lenore couldn't see which ones they were. Then she raised a small, hand-sized crossbow.
"No,"
Lenore whispered to herself in horror, even as the first bolt flew out. It struck the first servant in the middle of the back, and she fell, tumbling into the dirt. She rose up screaming, looking back toward the one who had shot her. That only meant that the second bolt took her through the chest. Lenore wanted to scream too, her heart breaking at the sight of an innocent girl she'd thought of almost as a friend being butchered for no reason.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.